Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we will discuss a question which says that first part, a rotation of 160 degrees counterclockwise is same as rotating the image by what angle in clockwise direction? And second part is, in the given figure, triangle M'M'M' is a reflection of triangle LMN and we have to find what is the line of reflection. Now let us start with the solution of the given question. Now in the first part we are asked that if we rotate a figure by 160 degrees in counterclockwise direction, then it is equal to rotating the image by what angle in clockwise direction? Now let us take alphabet P and let O be the point about which we have rotated this alphabet in counterclockwise direction by 160 degrees angle. So the image of this blue P is this red P, that is this red figure. Now if we rotate this blue P in clockwise direction, we will have to rotate it in this way so that it reaches the position of red P. Let we have rotated it by x degrees in clockwise direction. So let x degrees be angle of rotation in clockwise direction. Thus we have 160 degrees plus x degrees is equal to 360 degrees, that is total angle of full rotation. So this implies x degrees is equal to 360 degrees minus 160 degrees, which is equal to 200 degrees. Thus a rotation of 160 degrees counterclockwise is same as rotation of 200 degrees in clockwise direction. Now let us start with second part. Now here we are given two triangles such that triangle L'M'M' is reflected image of triangle LMN, and here we have to find line of reflection. Now by definition of line of reflection, we know that the pre-image point and the corresponding image point are equidistant from the line of reflection. That is, line of reflection is midpoint of the line segment joining the pre-image and image points. Also, line segment joining the corresponding image and pre-image points will be perpendicular to the line of reflection. So to find the line of reflection, we first join the pre-image points with their corresponding image points. So here, let us join L to L dash, M to M dash, N to N dash. Now by joining these points, we have line segments LL dash, MM dash and NN dash. Now here you can see MM dash is 2 units, that is the distance NN dash is 2 units, because here each square represents 1 unit. So 2 squares represent 2 units. Thus the mid distance of line segment MM dash is equal to 1 unit. So MM dash, that is the points MM dash, should be at a distance of 1 unit from the line of reflection. So we place the point at mid distance of the two points. Similarly, distance MM dash is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 units. So, mid distance of line segment MM dash is equal to 4 units. Thus, MMM dash, that is the points MMM dash, should be at a distance of 4 units from the line of reflection. So we place a point at mid distance of the two points. Now we join the two points and we see it is a horizontal line passing through y axis at the point 0, 1. Now let us extend this line in both the directions. So, this line cuts the y-axis at the point 0, 1. Thus, equation of the line of reflection is y is equal to 1. Now see the line segment LL dash. Now distance LL dash is equal to 4 units. Its mid distance is equal to 2 units. And we can see that both L and L dash are 2 units apart from the line y is equal to 1. So this is the solution of the given question. That's all for this session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.